Which one's the Raven? I don't know, somewhere in this room.
Don't move.
Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered, weak and weary, over a many quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, while I nodded, nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping, as of someone gently rapping, rapping at my chamber door.
"'Tis some visitor,"
I muttered,
"tapping at my chamber door." Only this and nothing more.
Ah, distinctly I remember. It was in the bleak December, and each separate dying ember wrought its ghost upon the floor. Eagerly I wished the morrow. Vainly I had sought to borrow from my books a crest of sorrow, sorrow for the lost Lenore. For the rare and radiant maiden whom the angels name Lenore, nameless here forevermore. And the silken, sad, and certain rustling of each purple curtain thrilled me, filled me with fantastic terrors never felt before. So that now to still the beating of my heart, I stood repeating,
"'Tis some visitor entreating entrance at my chamber door. Some late visitor entreating entrance at my chamber door. This it is and nothing more."
Presently my soul grew stronger, hesitating, then no longer.
"Sir,"
said I,
"or madam, truly your forgiveness I implore. But the fact is I was napping, and so gently you came rapping, and so faintly you came tapping, tapping at my chamber door, that I scarce was sure I heard you."
Here I opened wide the door. Darkness there, and nothing more. Deep into that darkness peering, long I stood there wondering, fearing, doubting, dreaming dreams no mortals ever dared to dream before. But the silence was unbroken, and the stillness gave no token, and the only word there spoken was the whispered word,
"Lenore."
This I whispered, and an echo murmured back the word,
"Lenore."
Nearly this, and nothing more. Back into the chamber turning, all my soul within me burning. Soon again I heard a tapping, something louder than before.
"Surely,"
said I,
"surely that is something at my window lattice. Let me see what then there is, and this mystery explore. Let my heart be still a moment, and this mystery explore."
Open here I flung the shutter, when with many a flirt and flutter, in the steps of stately raven of the changing days of yore, not the least obeisance made he, not a minute stopped or stayed, but with mean or lord or lady, perched above my chamber door, perched above the bust of palace, just above my chamber door, perched and sat, and nothing more. Then this ebony bird beguiling my sad face into smiling, by the grave and stern decorum of the countenance it wore.
"Though thy crest be shorn and shaven,"
I said,
"thou art sure no craven, ghastly, grim, and ancient raven, wandering the nightly shore. Tell me what thy lordly name is on the night Etonian shore."
Quoth the raven,
"Nevermore."
But the raven still beguiling all my fancy into smiling, straight I wheeled a cushioned seat in front of bread and button door. Then above the velvet sinking, I betook myself to linking fancy unto fancy, thinking what this ominous bird of yore, what this grim, ungainly, ghastly, gaunt, and ominous bird of yore meant in croaking no more. Then methought the air grew denser, perfume from an unseen censer, swung by seraphim whose footfalls tinkled on the turfed floor.
that God hath lent thee. By these angels he has sent me. Fight, whose fight and repent thee. From the memories of Lenore. Quaff, oh quaff, whose fight and repent thee. Forget this lost Lenore.
Quoth the raven,
nevermore.
Prophet,
said I,
thing of evil, prophet still, if bird or devil, by the heaven above us, or by the God we both adore, tell the soul of sorrow laden, if within the distant Aden, there's a clasp of Satan maiden, whom the angels name Lenore. Clasp a rare and maiden maiden, whom the angels name Lenore.
Quoth the raven,
nevermore.
I shrieked up, starting.
Get thee back into the tempest and the night's plummeting shore. Leave no black gloom as a token of that lie thy soul hath spoken. Leave my loneliness unbroken. Quit the bust above my door. Take thy beak from out my heart. Take thy form from off my door.
Quoth the raven,
nevermore.